This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Andrei René Roussimoff, May 19, 1946 to January 27, 1993, best known as Andre the Giant, was a French professional wrestler and actor. He most famously feuded with Hulk Hogan, culminating at WrestleMania 3, and his best remembered film role was that of Fezzik, the giant in The Princess Bride. His size was a result of gigantism caused by excess growth hormone, which later resulted in acromegaly. It also led to him being called the Eighth Wonder of the World. In the World Wrestling Federation WWF, now known as WWE, Andre was a one-time WWF World Heavyweight Champion and a one-time WWF Tag Team Champion in 1993. Andre was the inaugural inductee into the WWE Hall of Fame. Contents: 1. Early life. 2. Professional wrestling career. 21. Early career. 22. Worldwide Wrestling Federation. World Wrestling Federation 221. Undefeated streak. 1973-1988. 8-7-2-2-2 feud with Hulk Hogan. 1987-1988-223 feud with Jake Roberts and the Ultimate Warrior. 1988-1989-224 The Colossal Connection. 1989-1990-225 Sporadic appearances. 1990-1992-23 All Japan Pro Wrestling and Universal Wrestling Association. 1990-1992-3 Acting career. 31 Filmography. 4 Personal life. 5 Death. 6 Other media. 7 Legacy. 71 Possible biopic. 8 In wrestling. 9 Championships and accomplishments. 10 References. 11 External links. Early life. Andre Roussimoff was born in Coulommiers, France to Boris and Marianne Roussimoff, a couple of Bulgarian and Polish ancestry. His nickname growing up was Dede. As a child, he displayed symptoms of his gigantism very early, reaching a height of 191. Promoter who recognized the earning potential of Roussimoff's size. He trained at night and worked as a mover during the day to pay living expenses. Roussimoff was billed as Géant Ferré, a name based on the French folk hero Grand Ferré, and began wrestling in Paris and nearby areas. Canadian promoter and wrestler Frank Valois met Roussimoff in 1966, becoming his business manager and advisor. Roussimoff began making a name for himself wrestling in the United Kingdom, Germany, Australia, New Zealand, and Africa. He made his Japanese debut in 1970, billed as Monster Roussimoff, wrestling for the International Wrestling Enterprise Wrestling as both a singles and tag team competitor. He quickly was made the company's tag team champion alongside Michael Nader during his time in Japan. Doctors first informed Roussimoff that he suffered from acromegaly. Roussimoff next moved to Montreal, Canada, where he became an immediate success, regularly selling out the Montreal Forum. However, promoters eventually ran out of plausible opponents for him, and as the novelty of his size wore off, the gate receipts dwindled. Roussimoff was defeated by Adnan Al-Kaisi in Baghdad in 1971, and wrestled numerous times in 1972 for Vern Gagne's American Wrestling Association AWA as a special attraction until Valois appealed to Vince McMahon Sr., founder of the Worldwide Wrestling Federation WWWF, for advice. McMahon suggested several changes. He felt Roussimoff should be portrayed as a large, immovable monster, and to enhance the perception of his size, McMahon discouraged Roussimoff from performing maneuvers such as dropkicks. Although he was capable of performing such agile maneuvers before his health deteriorated in later life, he also began billing Roussimoff as Andre the Giant and set up a travel-intensive schedule, loaning him to wrestling associations around the world. To keep him from becoming overexposed in any area, promoters had to guarantee Andre a certain amount of money as well as pay McMahon's WWF booking fee. Worldwide Wrestling Federation, World Wrestling Federation undefeated streak 1973-1987. On March 26, 1973, Andre debuted in the Worldwide Wrestling Federation, later World Wrestling Federation, as a fan favorite, defeating Buddy Wolf in New York's Madison Square Garden. Andre was one of professional wrestling's most beloved babyfaces throughout the 1970s and early 1980s. As such, Gorilla Monsoon often stated that Andre had never been defeated for 15 years by pinfall or submission prior to WrestleMania 3. However, Andre had lost lost in matches outside of the WWF, a pinfall loss in Mexico to Konecki in 1984 and a submission loss in Japan to Antonio Inoki in 1986. He also had 60-minute time limit draws with the two other major world champions of the day, Harley Race and Nick Bockwinkel in 1976. Andre fought professional boxer Chuck Wepner in an unscripted boxer versus wrestler fight. The wild fight was shown via telecast as part of the undercard of the Muhammad Ali versus Antonio Inoki fight and ended when Andre threw Wepner over the top rope and outside the ring in 1980. He feuded with Hulk Hogan, wrestling him at Shea Stadium's Showdown at Shea and in Pennsylvania. The feud continued in Japan in 1982 and 1983. In 1982, Vince McMahon Sr. sold the Worldwide Wrestling Federation to his son, Vince McMahon Jr. As McMahon began to expand his newly acquired promotion to the national level, he required his wrestlers to appear exclusively for him. McMahon signed Andre to these terms in 1984, although he still allowed him to work in Japan for New Japan Pro Wrestling NJPW. One of Andre's feuds pitted him against the Mongolian giant Killer Khan. According to the storyline, Khan had snapped Andre's ankle during a match on May 2, 1981, in Rochester, New York, by leaping off the top rope and crashing down upon it with his knee drop. In reality, Andre had broken his ankle getting out of bed the morning before the match. The injury and subsequent rehabilitation was worked into the existing Andre Khan storyline. After a stay at Beth Israel Hospital in Boston, Andre returned with Payback on his mind. The two battled on July 20, 1981, at Madison Square Garden in a match that resulted in a double disqualification. Their feud continued as fans filled arenas up and down the East Coast to witness their matches. On November 14, 1981, at the Philadelphia Spectrum, Andre decisively defeated Khan in what was billed as a Mongolian stretcher match, in which the loser must be taken to the dressing room on a stretcher. The same type of match was also held in Toronto in early 1982. The two also fought in a series of matches in Japan with Arnold Skolin in Andre's corner. Andre, second from right, feuded with Big John Studd left in the build towards WrestleMania I, and later with King Kong Bundy, second from left. Another feud involved a man who considered himself to be the true giant of wrestling, Big John Studd. Throughout the early to mid-1980s, Andre and Studd fought all over the world, battling to try to determine who the real giant of wrestling was. In 1984, Studd took the feud to a new level when he and partner Ken Patera knocked out Andre during a televised tag team match and proceeded to cut off Andre's hair after gaining revenge on Patera. Andre met Studd in a body slam challenge at the first WrestleMania, held March 31, 1985, at Madison Square Garden in New York City. Andre slammed Studd to win the match and collect the $15,000 prize, then proceeded to throw cash to the fans before having the bag taken from him by Studd's manager, Bobby "The Brain" Heenan, the following year. At WrestleMania II, on April 7, 1986, Andre continued to display his dominance by winning a 20-man battle royal which featured top National Football League stars and wrestlers. Andre last eliminated Bret Hart to win the contest. After WrestleMania II, Andre continued his feud with Studd and King Kong Bundy. Around this time, Andre requested a leave of absence to tend to his health, effects from his acromegaly that were beginning to take their toll, as well as tour Japan. He had also been cast in the film The Princess Bride to explain Andre's absence. A storyline was developed in which Heenan, suggesting that Andre was secretly afraid of Studd and Bundy, whom Heenan bragged were unbeatable, challenged Andre and a partner of his choosing to wrestle Studd and Bundy in a televised tag team match. When Andre failed to show, WWF president Jack Tunney indefinitely suspended him later in the summer of 1986. Upon Andre's return to the United States, he began wearing a mask and competing as the Giant Machine in a stable known as the Machines. Big Machine and Super Machine were the other members. The WWF's television announcers sold the Machines, a gimmick that was copied from the New Japan Pro Wrestling character Super Strong Machine, played by Japanese wrestler Junji Harada, as a new tag team from Japan, and claimed not to know the identities of the wrestlers, even though it was obvious to fans that it was Andre competing as the Giant Machine. Heenan, Studd, and Bundy complained to Tunney, who eventually told Heenan that if it could be proven that Andre and the Giant Machine were the same person, Andre would be fired. Andre thwarted Heenan, Studd, and Bundy at every turn. Then, in late 1986, the Giant Machine disappeared, and Andre was reinstated, foreshadowing Andre's heel turn. Heenan expressed his approval of the reinstatement but did not explain why. Feud with Hulk Hogan 1987-1988. Andre was managed by Bobby Heenan, seen in front of him during parts of his feud with Hulk Hogan. Andre agreed to turn heel in early 1987 to be the counter to the biggest babyface in professional wrestling at that time, Hulk Hogan, on an edition of Piper's Pit in 1987. Hogan was presented a trophy for being the WWF World Heavyweight Champion for 3 years. Andre came out to congratulate him on the following week's Piper's Pit. Andre was presented a slightly smaller trophy for being the only undefeated wrestler in wrestling history. Although Andre had suffered a handful of countout and disqualification losses in WWF, he had never been pinned or forced to submit in a WWF ring. Hogan came out to congratulate Andre and ended up being the focal point of the interview, apparently annoyed. Andre walked out in the midst of Hogan's speech. A discussion between Andre and Hogan was scheduled, and on a Piper's Pit that aired February 7, 1987, the two met. Hogan was introduced first, followed by Andre. Andre was led by longtime rival Bobby Heenan. Speaking on behalf of his new protege, Heenan accused Hogan of only being Andre's friend so he would not have to defend his title against him. Hogan tried to reason with Andre, but his pleas were ignored as he challenged Hogan to a match for the WWF World Heavyweight Championship at WrestleMania 3. Hogan was still seemingly in disbelief as to what Andre was doing, prompting Heenan to say, "You can't believe it, maybe you'll believe this, Hogan," before Andre ripped the t-shirt and crucifix from Hogan. Andre's fingernail scratched Hogan's chest while ripping the shirt off, which caused Hogan to bleed. Following Hogan's acceptance of Andre's challenge on a later edition of Piper's Pit, the two were part of a 20-man over-the-top rope battle royal on the March 14th edition of Saturday Night's Main Event at the Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Although the battle royal was won by Hercules, Andre claimed to have gained a psychological advantage over Hogan when he threw the WWF World Heavyweight Champion over the top rope. The match, which was actually taped on February 21, 1987, aired only 2 weeks before WrestleMania 3 to make it seem like Hogan had met his match in Andre the Giant at WrestleMania 3. He was billed at 520. Until the day of the event, if Andre would lose the match. In reality, Andre had agreed to lose the match some time before, mostly for health reasons, though he almost pinned Hogan, albeit unintentionally, in the first minute of the match after Hogan tried to slam him but could not hold his weight. Contrary to popular belief, it was not the first time that Hogan had successfully body slammed Andre in a WWF match. A then heel Hogan slammed a then face Andre following their match at the Showdown at Shea on August 9, 1980, though Andre was much lighter around 470. Survivor of the match, pinning Bam Bam Bigelow before Hogan returned to the ring to attack Andre and knock him out of the ring. Andre later got revenge when, after Hogan won a match against Bundy on Saturday Night's Main Event, he snuck up from behind and began choking Hogan to the brink of unconsciousness, not letting go even after an army of seven face-aligned wrestlers ran to the ring to try to pull Andre away. It took Hacksaw Jim Duggan breaking a 2x4 over Andre's back, which he no-sold for him to let go, after which Hogan was pulled to save safety, as was the case with the SNME Battle Royal a year earlier. The series of events was one of the pieces that helped build interest in a possible one-on-one rematch between Hogan and Andre, and to make it seem that Andre was certain to win easily when they did meet in the meantime. The Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase failed to persuade Hogan to sell him the WWF World Heavyweight Championship after failing to defeat Hogan in a subsequent series of matches. DiBiase turned to Andre to win it for him. Andre and DiBiase had teamed several times in the past, including in Japan and in the WWF in the late 1970s and early 1980s when both were faces, but this was not acknowledged during this new storyline. The earlier attack and DiBiase's insertion into the feud set up the Hogan-Andre rematch on the Main Event, to air February 5, 1988, on a live broadcast on NBC. Acting as his hired gun, Andre won the WWF World Heavyweight Championship from Hogan, his first singles title, in a match where it was later revealed that appointed referee Dave Hebner was detained backstage, and a replacement whom Hogan afterwards initially accused of having been paid by DiBiase to get plastic surgery to look like Dave, but in fact was revealed to have been his evil twin brother, Earl Hebner, made a 3-count on Hogan while his shoulders were off the mat after winning. Andre sold the title to DiBiase. The transaction was declared invalid by then WWF president Jack Tunney, and the title was declared vacant. This was shown on WWF's NBC program The Main Event at WrestleMania IV. Andre and Hulk Hogan fought to a double disqualification disqualification in a WWF title tournament match with the idea in the storyline saying that Andre was again working on DiBiase's behalf in giving DiBiase a clearer path in the tournament afterward. Andre and Hogan's feud died down after a steel cage match held at WrestleFest on July 31, 1988, in Milwaukee at the inaugural SummerSlam pay-per-view held at Madison Square Garden. Andre and DiBiase billed as the Mega Bucks faced Hogan and WWF World Heavyweight Champion Macho Man Randy Savage, known as the Mega Powers, in the main event, with Jesse the Body Ventura as the special guest referee during the match. The Mega Powers' manager, Miss Elizabeth, Savage's wife Elizabeth Hewlett, distracted the Mega Bucks and Ventura when she climbed up on the ring apron, removed her yellow skirt and walked around in a pair of red panties. This allowed Hogan and Savage time to recover and eventually win the match, with Hogan pinning DiBiase. Savage forced Ventura's hand down for the final three count, due to Ventura's character historically being at odds with Hogan, and his unwillingness to count the fall concurrent with the developing feud with the Mega Powers. Andre was placed in a feud with Jim Duggan, which began after Duggan knocked out Andre with a 2x4 board during a television taping. Despite Duggan's popularity with fans, Andre regularly got the upper hand in the feud with Jake Roberts and the Ultimate Warrior. 1988-1989, Andre feuded with Jake Roberts based on Andre's fear of snakes. Andre's next major feud was against Jake the Snake Roberts. In this storyline, it was said Andre was afraid of snakes, something Roberts exposed on Saturday night's main event when he threw his snake, Damien, on the frightened Andre. As a result, Andre suffered a kayfabe mild heart attack and vowed revenge during the next few weeks. Roberts frequently walked to ringside during Andre's matches, causing him to run from the ring in fright since he knew what was inside the bag throughout their feud, which culminated at WrestleMania V. Roberts constantly used Damien to gain a psychological edge over the much larger and stronger Andre. In 1989, Andre and the returning Big John Studd briefly reprised their feud, beginning at WrestleMania V, when Studd was the referee in the match with Roberts, this time with Studd as a face and Andre as the heel. During the late summer and fall of 1989, Andre engaged in a brief feud, almost entirely consisting of house shows, non-televised events, with then Intercontinental Champion The Ultimate Warrior. The younger Warrior, WWF's rising star, regularly squashed the aging Andre in an attempt to showcase his star quality and promote him as the next big thing. The Colossal Connection. 1989-1990 main article, The Colossal Connection. In late 1989, Andre was joined with fellow Heenan family member Haku to form a new tag team called The Colossal Connection, in part to fill a void left by the departure of Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson, the Brain Busters, who were also members of Heenan's stable from the WWF, and also to continue to keep the aging Andre in the main event spotlight. The Colossal Connection immediately targeted WWF tag team champions Demolition, who had recently won the belts from the Brain Busters at a television taping on December 13, 1989. The Colossal Connection defeated Demolition to win the titles. Andre and Haku successfully defended their title, mostly against Demolition, until WrestleMania V on April 1, 1990, when Demolition took advantage of a mistimed move by the champions to regain the belts after the match. A furious Heenan blamed Andre for the title loss and, after shouting at him, slapped him in the face. An angry Andre responded with a slap of his own that sent Heenan staggering from the ring. Andre also caught Haku's kick attempt, sending him reeling from the ring as well, prompting support for Andre and turning him face for the first time since 1987 due to his ongoing health issues. Andre was not able to wrestle at the time of WrestleMania V, and Haku actually wrestled the entire match against Demolition without tagging in Andre on weekend television shows following WrestleMania V. Bobby Heenan vowed to spit in Andre's face when he came crawling back to the Heenan family. However, Andre would wrestle one more time with Haku, teaming up to face Demolition on a house show in Honolulu, Hawaii. On April 10, Andre was knocked out of the ring and the Colossal Connection lost via countout. After the match, Andre and Haku would fight each other, marking the end of the team. Andre's final match of 1990 came at a combined WWF, All Japan, New Japan show on April 13 in Tokyo, Japan, when teamed with Giant Baba to defeat Demolition in a non-title match. Andre would win by gaining the pinfall on Smash. Sporadic appearances. 1990-1992, Andre returned in the winter of 1990, but it was not to the World Wrestling Federation. Instead, Andre made an interview appearance for Herb Abrams' fledgling Universal Wrestling Federation Federation on October 11 in Reseda, CA. The segment aired in 1991. He appeared in an interview segment with Captain Lou Albano and put over the UWF the following month. On November 30 at a house show in Miami, Florida, the World Wrestling Federation announced Andre's return as a participant in the 1991 Royal Rumble to be held in Miami, Florida. 2 months later, Andre was also mentioned as a participant on television but would ultimately back out due to a leg injury. His on-air return finally came at WrestleMania 7, when he came to the aid of the Big Boss Man in his match against Mr. Perfect. Andre finally returned to action on April 26, 1991, in a six-man tag team matchup when he teamed with the Rockers in a winning effort against Mr. Fuji and the Orient Express at a house show in Belfast, Northern Ireland. On May 10, he participated in a 17-man battle royal at a house show in Detroit, won by Kerry Von Erich. His last major WWF story line following WrestleMania 7 had the major heel managers Bobby Heenan, Sensational Sherry, Slick, and Mr. Fuji trying to recruit Andre one by one, only to be turned down in various humiliating ways, e.g. Heenan had his hand crushed, Sherry received a spanking, Slick got locked in the trunk of the car he was offering to Andre, and Mr. Fuji got a pie in his face. Finally, Jimmy Hart appeared live on WWF Superstars to announce that he had successfully signed Andre to tag team with Earthquake. However, when asked to confirm this by Gene Okerlund, Andre denied the claims. This led to Earthquake attacking Andre from behind, injuring his knee. Jimmy Hart would later get revenge for the humiliation by secretly signing Tugboat and forming the Natural Disasters. This led to Andre's final major WWF appearance at SummerSlam 91, where he seconded the Bushwhackers in their match against the Disasters. Andre was on crutches at ringside, and after the Disasters won the match, they set out to attack Andre, but the Legion of Doom made their way to ringside and got in between them and the Giant, who was preparing to defend himself with one of his crutches. The Disasters left the ringside area as they were outnumbered by the Legion of Doom, the Bushwhackers, and Andre, who struck both Earthquake and Typhoon. The former Tugboat with the crutch as they left. His final WWF appearance came at a house show in Paris, France. On October 9, he was in Davy Boy Smith's corner as the Bulldog faced Earthquake. Davy Boy hit Earthquake with Andre's crutch, allowing Smith to win. His last U.S. television appearance was in a brief interview on World Championship Wrestling's WCW Clash of the Champions XX special that aired on TBS on September 2, 1992. All Japan Pro Wrestling and Universal Wrestling Association 1990-1992. After WrestleMania V, Andre spent the rest of his in-ring career in All Japan Pro Wrestling AJPW and Mexico's Universal Wrestling Association, where he performed under the name Andre El Gigante. He toured with AJPW three times per year, from 1990 to 1992, usually teaming with Giant Baba in tag team matches. He also made a couple of guest appearances for Herb Abrams' Universal Wrestling Federation, in 1991, feuding with Big John Studd. Though he never had a match in the promotion, he did his final tour of Mexico in 1992 in a selection of six-man tag matches alongside Bam Bam Bigelow and a variety of Lucha Libre stars, facing among others Bad News Allen and future WWF champion Yokozuna. Andre wrestled his final match for AJPW in 1992. After his final match, Andre retired from professional wrestling. In the process acting career, Andre branched out into acting again in the 1970s and 1980s, after a 1967 French boxing movie, making his USA acting debut playing a Sasquatch Bigfoot in a two-part episode aired in 1976 on the 1970s television series The $6 Million Man. He appeared in other television shows, including The Greatest American Hero, BJ and the Bear, The Fall Guy, and 1990s Zorro. Towards the end of his career, Andre starred in several films. He had an uncredited appearance in the 1984 film Conan the Destroyer as Doggett, the resurrected horned giant god who is killed by Conan. Arnold Schwarzenegger that same year. Andre also made an appearance in Mickey, BJ and the Bear, Snow White and the Seven Lady Truckers 1981, Manny Felcher The Greatest American Hero, Heaven Is in Your Jeans 1983, Monster, The Goonies Are Good Enough music video by Cyndi Lauper, Conan the Destroyer 1984, Doggett uncredited Mickey. In her autobiography that Andre drank 127 beers in a Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, hotel bar and later passed out in the lobby, the staff could not move him and had to leave him there until he awoke. A tale recounted by Cary Elwes in his book about the making of The Princess Bride has Andre falling atop somebody while drunk, after which the NYPD sent an undercover officer to follow Rusimov around whenever he went out drinking in their city and make sure he didn't fall on anyone again. An urban legend exists surrounding Andre's 1987 surgery in which his size made it impossible for the anesthesiologist to estimate a dosage via standard methods. Consequently, his alcohol tolerance was used as a guideline instead. Andre was arrested by the Linn County, Iowa, sheriff in 1989 and charged with assault after he allegedly roughed up a local television cameraman. William Goldman, the author of the novel and the screenplay of The Princess Bride, wrote in his non-fiction work Which Lie Did I Tell that Andre was one of the gentlest and most generous people he ever knew. Whenever Andre ate with someone in a restaurant, he would pay, but he would also insist on paying when he was a guest after one meal. Arnold Schwarzenegger had quietly moved to the cashier to pay before Andre could, but then found himself being physically lifted, carried from his table, and deposited on top of his car by Andre and Wilt Chamberlain. Death. Rusimov died in his sleep of congestive heart failure on the night of January 27, 1993, in a Paris hotel room. He was found by his chauffeur. He was in Paris attending his father's funeral. His body was cremated according to his wishes and his ashes were scattered at his ranch 35 degrees 06 58 N 79 degrees 48 minutes 23 seconds west, 35,116,211 degrees north, 7,980,634 degrees west, 35,116,211, minus 7,980,634. Rusimov Ranch in Ellerbe, North Carolina. Other media. Andre has made appearances as himself in video games for years, as early as 1989's WWF Superstars, where he appears as a non-playable game boss along with Ted DiBiase, fighting as their real-life tag team the Mega Bucks. He is also playable in WWF No Mercy, WWE 2K14, released in 2013, where he appears as one of many playable legend characters, and WWE 2K15, as part of the Path of the Warrior DLC. He also appears in WWE Day of Reckoning, WWE SmackDown vs. Raw, WWE SmackDown vs. Raw 2006, and WWE All-Stars as a playable legend character. Andre currently appears in WWE 2K16 and uses his character render shot picture from WWE 2K14, which is given to him in this title. Andre the Giant and Haku are known as the Colossal Connection in this game. He also appears in WWE Legends of WrestleMania. He was also confirmed for WWE 2K17 on January 25, 2005. WWE released Andre the Giant, a DVD focusing on the life and career of Andre. The DVD is a reissue of the out-of-print Andre the Giant VHS made by Coliseum Video. In 1985, with commentary by Michael Cole and Taz replacing Gorilla Monsoon and Jesse Ventura's commentary on his WrestleMania match with Big John Studd, the video is hosted by Lord Alfred Hayes. Later matches, including Andre's battles against Hulk Hogan while a heel, are not included on this VHS. Legacy. Big Show, a wrestler often compared with Andre due to his size, was the winner of the 2015 Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal at WrestleMania 31, and is posing alongside the Andre the Giant Memorial Trophy, which goes to the winner of the annual match in 1993, when the then World Wrestling Federation created the WWF Hall of Fame. Andre the Giant was the inaugural and sole inductee. Andre was the inspiration for the 1998 film My Giant, written by his friend Billy Crystal, whom he had met during the filming of The Princess Bride. Paul White, better known as Big Show, is more similar in body structure to Andre than any other wrestler since Andre's death. He was originally billed as the son of Andre during his stint in WCW when he was known as simply The Giant, despite there being no biological relationship, while also suffering from acromegaly. Unlike Andre, White did get surgery on his pituitary gland in the early 1990s, which successfully halted the progress of his condition. The former wrestler Giant Gonzalez suffered from problems similar to those that Andre had near the end of his life and died in 2010 due to diabetes complications. In 1999, Andre was the subject of an episode of A Mandy Patinkin and others on the March 10, 2014, episode of Raw, WrestleMania XXX host Hulk Hogan announced that in honor of Andre's legacy, he was establishing the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal, that would take place at the event, with the winner receiving the Andre the Giant Memorial Trophy made in the likeness of Andre on April 6, 2014, at WrestleMania XXX. Cesaro won the match after eliminating Big Show using a body slam similar to the body slam Hulk Hogan used on Andre at WrestleMania 3. At WrestleMania 31, the second annual Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal took place at Levi's Stadium, establishing the match as a yearly tradition at WWE's marquee event. Big Show won the event, last eliminating Damian Mizdow at the third annual Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal. Baron Corbin eliminated Kane to win the match. Wrestler times date location WrestleMania notes Cesaro 1-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-2-0-1-4-0-4-0-6-0-0-0-0 April 6, 2014 New Orleans, Louisiana XXX won by last eliminating Big Show. Big Show 1-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-2-0-1-5-0-3-2-9-0-0-0-0 March 29, 2015 Santa Clara, California 31 won by last eliminating Damian Mizdow. Baron Corbin 1-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-2-0-1-6-0-4-0-3 April 3, 2016 Arlington, Texas 32 won by last eliminating Kane. Possible biopic on May 9, 2016, it was announced that a movie based on the 2015 authorized graphic novel biography Andre the Giant, Closer to Heaven was in the plans made by Lion Forge Comics along with producers Scott Steindorf, Dylan Russell and consulted by Andre's daughter, Robin Christensen. Rusamoff in wrestling finishing moves double underhook suplex elbow drop sit down splash signature moves bear hug big boot body slam chokehold double choke forehand chop headbutt knee strike to an opponent's middle section knife edged chop. Multiple turnbuckle thrust standing on a fallen, cornered opponent walking on a fallen opponent's stomach. Managers Lou Albano, Ted DiBiase, Bobby Heenan, Frank Valois, Arnold Skolin, K.Y. Wakamatsu. Nicknames The Boss, The Wildcat, The Eighth Wonder of the World. Entrance themes Giant Press. NJPW Giant by Jim Johnston used in various WWE video games. Avenue Satanist by John Christopher Payne used in WWE 2K14, WWE 2K15, WWE 2K16 and WWE 2K17 Championships and Accomplishments. Championship Wrestling from Florida. NWA Florida Tag Team Championship one time, with Dusty Rhodes. International Pro Wrestling. IWA World Tag Team Championship one time, with Michael Nader. NWA Hollywood Los Angeles Battle Royal 1975, 1980. NWA San Francisco Cow Palace Battle Royal 1977. New Japan Pro Wrestling. International Wrestling Grand Prix 1985. MSG League 1982. MSG Tag League 1981 with Rene Goulet. Sagawa Express Cup 1986. NWA Tri-State. NWA United States Tag Team Championship Tri-State version one time, with Dusty Rhodes. Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame and Museum Class of 2002. Pro Wrestling Illustrated Most Popular Wrestler of the Year 1977, 1982. Match of the Year 1981 versus Killer Khan on the 2nd of May. Match of the Year 1988 versus Hulk Hogan at the main event. Most Hated Wrestler of the Year 1988. Editor's Award 1993. Ranked number 3 of the top 500 singles wrestlers of the PWI years in 2003. Stampede Wrestling. Stampede Wrestling Hall of Fame. World Championship Wrestling Australia. NWA Austra Asian Tag Team Championship one time, with Ron Miller. World Wrestling Federation. WWE WWF Tag Team Championship one time, with Haku. WWF World Heavyweight Championship one time. WWE Bronze Statue. WWF Hall of Fame Class of 1993. Wrestling Observer Newsletter. Feud of the Year 1981 versus Killer Khan. Most Embarrassing Wrestler 1989. Worst Feud of the Year 1984 versus Big John Studd. Worst Feud of the Year 1989 versus The Ultimate Warrior. Worst Worked Match of the Year 1987 versus Hulk Hogan at WrestleMania 3. Worst Worked Match of the Year 1989 versus The Ultimate Warrior on October 31st. Worst Tag Team 1990, 1991 with Giant Baba. Worst Wrestler 1989 1989, 1991, 1992 Wrestling Observer Newsletter Hall of Fame Class of 1996 References Notes Carat A B C D E F G H I J K L M N O Andre the Giant Profile Online World of Wrestling Archived from the original on September 21, 2008 Retrieved September 22, 2008 The official site of Andre the Giant, biography, retrieved May 18, 2009. ISBN. Carat Krugman 2009, pp. Raging 80s Simon & Schuster pp. Carat WWF at Tampa, Florida, Sundome, January 26, 1987. The History of WWE archived from the original on May 10, 2011 retrieved March 27, 2011. pp. Carat Andre the Giant October 23, 2014 Andre the Giant.